Welcome to a new episode of Melt. I'm Ritvika Gupta. Tata Consultancy Services has unveiled a new brand statement called Building on Belief. The new brand purpose showcases how TCS is playing a more active and collaborative role with its customers and helping them build and shape futures. Let's first take a look at the film. To know more about the branding exercise and to better understand what TCS's new brand promise means, Anant Rangaswamy, editor of Melt, will be interviewing Rajashree R, Chief Marketing Officer, TCS. Let's get ready to Melt with Rajashree R.
Morning, Rajashree.
Good morning, Anant. Thanks for having me. Nice to meet you.
So, lovely to talk to you at a time like this. So, to begin with, tell me your brand statement or brand articulation, which is building on belief. Tell me what it means first to sure. the layperson.
Sure. So Anant, we wanted to develop a brand statement which truly symbolizes who we are as TCS today and our aspirations in the future, right? We wanted to talk about what we represent to our customers. And if you look at our history, if you look at the work that we do, we would call ourselves a very purpose-led transformation organization, right? We make technology work for our clients, for the communities, for the industries, but very deeply rooted in the purpose of making the world a better place, right? We wanted to have a brand statement which articulates this ethos, it articulates this message. And therefore, two very beautiful words coming together, building and belief. As we know, everything that we do in our life, you know, all great things are born out of belief, be it an organization, be it we as individuals, be it mega projects which are launched, right? What we have at the core is belief. And building is a testimony to who we are as an organization, right? When we did the research towards developing the statement, we were told that we are a company which makes things happen. We make technology happen in the context of the clients, right? And therefore, building is a testimony to that. So two really beautiful words coming together seamlessly, building on belief.
So Rajashree, tell me, how will this brand statement manifest itself, say, to your internal stakeholders? Now, you know, TCS is one of the highest employers in the country. So it's important that they need to understand what this means. They need to feel it. So tell me, how will this manifest itself to them?
Sure. Anand, that's a very good question. As you know, we have more than 470,000 employees across the world. As the CMO of the company, I look at all of these 470,000 people as the brand ambassadors of the company, right? Especially in a B2B marketing environment, it's not the advertisement, it's not the social media messages which first reach our customers. It's our employees who reach the customers on a daily basis. So it is of paramount importance to us that our employees imbibe it, adopt it, understand the spirit behind it and are able to articulate it in a very structured manner to our customers and articulate the passion behind it, right? So needless to say, our focus as far as the go-to-market for this brand platform is our employees first. We have already started the process. We have done a lot of town halls, a lot of messaging, a lot of content that has been put out in our internal channels where we are articulating the message. But this is a long journey, and we are constantly going to focus on making sure these messages are getting communicated. We are also launching a lot of employee-generated programs, right? So we are going to ask, for example, our employees to talk about their belief stories, right? Talk about their stories of how belief came to life in their context of their work or context of their personal life. So as you rightly put, employees first, as far as this brand launch is concerned, you know, very, very important for us. And we have an absolutely systematic program which is focused on driving that.
Right. Now, being in the IT space, you're also continuous, you're a continuous employer, if I can call it that.
Yes.
So how will this translate into employer brand? How will prospective candidate see the change in your brand statement, and how will he or she experience it?
Yeah, again, a very good question, Anand. So I talk about our stakeholder map, right? For us, obviously, the first stakeholders are our customers, you know, the 2,000, 3,000 top companies in the world who work with us. The second group, which is very important, is obviously our own employees, but also prospective employees, the youngsters across the world who have to make a choice of which organization they belong to. And of course, then we have the larger shareholders and partners and all of that, right? If you look at a youngster today, and we have seen it in many, many forums, millennials especially want to work with organizations where they believe that their work will be worthwhile, right? If you talk to a youngster today, they want to be associated with brands and organizations who are purpose-led, right? And they want to believe that finally they are able to contribute to the world in a positive way. So I really think that building on, in fact, this was a very important criteria for us. When we developed this brand position, we wanted to make sure that it resonated with that youngster who's actually coming into the organization. So you will see this very, very strongly articulated in our hiring campaigns and our, you know, student engagement programs that we run very actively across the globe. And we think it's a great platform to actually get the youngster to come and join TCS. So you will see that being actively used, Anand, going forward.
Yeah. Rajeshri, you know, I'm a fairly deep-rooted cynic when it comes to brand purpose.
Yeah.
You know, where, you know, you got a soap with a purpose, you got a toothpaste with a purpose, and then you got, you know, the other extreme of, say, Mahindra Rise or what you're doing and so on.
Yeah.
But they're difficult to communicate because they're intangible. You know, the purpose is not like a black box.
Yes, yes.
So tell me, how do you deal with the intangibility of a statement?
Yeah. Anand, I'll tell you my views, and I think my views are probably very similar to your views. You know, purpose is a word which has been, you know, sort of used a lot, especially in the recent past. When we set out this journey, we did not say we wanted a purpose. We said we are going to find our purpose, right? If you look at the history of our organization, we've been leaders for the last 50, 60 years. Employees in our company have longevity. People have worked here for 20 years, 30 years, right? You would have heard about these stories. And every you know, CEO we've had in the company has come from the ranks. Every major leader in the company has come from the ranks. So the question we asked ourselves is, what is it which motivates all of us to work in this company for such a long time? What is it that makes us wake up in the morning and feel energized and motivated for 20 years and 25 years and do our job? It can't just mean the tangibles. It can't just mean a promotion or a salary. It can't mean that. It has to be more than that. So this exercise was not really, I would say, a marketing or a consulting exercise of finding a nice purpose statement, but it was really trying to find what motivates us and what is it that makes us work for this great organization for all these years. And therefore, the purpose statement which we have, which is, you know, building great futures with innovation and collective knowledge, was not something which we are sort of, you know, sticking onto our organization. I strongly believe that this is organically generated. This came through the conversations of our employees and our customers. And everyone that I've talked to, and if you look at even our social media posts, you know, our employees are saying this feels like TCS. And for me, I can't look for a greater endorsement than that. So I think this is not a slapped on purpose. This truly reflects who we are as an organization and what motivates us every day as we come to work. So I'm hoping that this will really work for us.
Right. Now, while I said I don't want to talk about money or on a pound shillings and pence basis, you know, you obviously investing a lot of money in this purpose statement.
Sure.
How would you measure your ROI on it? You know, 5 years from now, how will you see it? How will Bombay House see it? You know, they'll say, you know, how do they say, well done, this was money well invested?
Yeah. I think there are a couple of things. The first thing, for example, for us is the ability, this platform has to really provide the strength to our business teams, the teams on the ground, the delivery teams. They have to provide them the wings to tell their message much more strongly or position themselves much better, right? And that can always, that always means growth in our world, Anand. So, you know, this definitely has to be a platform that supports growth of our organization. We've said next horizon of growth or next decade of growth. You know, definitely we will be measuring this on how well this positioning is actually helping our organization support the teams and support us to grow both on a medium term and long term, right? Second is, I think overall brand recall, the brand mind share. You know, I am very ambitious about TCS as a brand. I think while, you know, all the reports that we get, we are already the number three IT services brand. But I think nothing stops us to take this brand to further heights. You know, why can't TCS be one of the biggest brands that's come out of India, right? Why we should be having that aspiration. So definitely we want to see the brand grow. We want to see the brand gain the prominence that I think it truly deserves as one of the pioneering organizations in the world. So I think driving growth for the organization and building the brand TCS, I think, are the two main measures. I'm not sharing the numbers behind it, but yeah, those are the two measures I think we will largely measure ourselves on. And of course, does it make every TCS proud? Is that probably another important measure that we measure it on.
Right. And how often and how will you be tracking these measures?
We have very systematic methods. If you see my personal background, I built product teams, I built an AI before I took on to this job. So trust me when I tell you this, that we have a very structured, quantitative approach to measure the effectiveness of marketing. We measure brand effectiveness. We measure all our programs. And I can tell you that there is a very significant data-driven approach behind measuring marketing in general, but brand specifically as well.
In the past 8-10 months, you know, post-pandemic, we've had at Melt, we've had a number of conversations with people who measure reputation. And yes. One of the conversations was with Richard Edelman.
Yeah.
And all their studies point to trust being a very big component that
exactly.
Consumers seek today.
Exactly.
From companies. Now, I went through all your statements and I'm not seeing the word trust pop out. I was hoping it pops out. So tell me, where does trust fit into your current scheme of things?
Yeah, Anand, you've done a good job of going through our material. But in our manifesto statement, the second last statement says trust. It says instilling trust into enterprise. And we have been tracking the trust barometer report of Edelman as well. And if you see that report, it basically says that businesses are high on the performance curve and not so high on the trust curve. And Richard Edelman must have spoken about it, right? I think we are in a very unique position as a business because, you know, with obviously the Tata legacy as well, which is, you know, obviously backing us, TCS is seen as a very trustworthy, value-centric company. In fact, when we did this research as part of this brand positioning exercise, the first thing which came out was something called In It For Good, which, you know, I'm very proud of personally. So In It For Good says that this company is doing things for the right reasons, right? Right reasons for the community, right reasons for its employees, and right reasons for its customers, right? So that came through as a very important, I would say, characteristic and strength of the organization. And therefore, you see in our manifesto statement, the word trust, And you'll also see that word in our videos, Anant. And it's a very important trait. We might articulate it in different words, but being value-centric, being purpose-led, living our beliefs is actually what Building on Belief is all about. So you will see that articulated very strongly in our messaging going forward.
Right. So you've always been, when I say always, certainly for the last 15, 20 years, you've been a fairly large communicator internationally.
Yes.
Especially in the North American.
Yes.
And now tell me, how will this roll out in North America? How will the average Fortune 500 company CEO receive this message that this is what TCS has done?
Yeah. So Anant, I have an interesting way of saying it. I always say Janma Bhoomi and Karma Bhoomi, right? So India being our Janma Bhoomi, but obviously North America, Europe, UK is being our Karma Bhoomi, because most of our business is centered around those markets. So we are taking a very market specific approach. There is obviously the global brand launch we've just started yesterday. But you will see very, very strong activation plans in each of these markets. Obviously, the first group that we are going to go after is the business community. So you'll see this being activated in the media and the channels which business community reads and goes to. That is definitely going to be one. A very big platform for us is a lot of customer events. Anant, we obviously, some of them did not happen during the pandemic and many of them went virtual, but we do a lot of intimate customer events. We call it customer summit, innovation forums. So these are very high quality, intimate events that we do in these markets, and we will obviously be leveraging that to propagate our message. Another very important platform for us is running and marathons, and we sponsor about 20 marathons across the world. So everything from New York Marathon to Mumbai to Bangalore to London to Amsterdam to Canberra. I mean, that's a very important platform for us. And belief as a statement is probably best proved when you're trying to run a marathon, because when an ordinary man says, I want to run 42 kilometers, if he doesn't believe he can do it, he will never be able to do it, right? So you will see us using some of these existing platforms to activate this brand much more strongly. But we will also work on creating some new platforms as well, which makes sense for our audience. So a very strong activation you will see in some of our major markets.
From your Karma Bhoomi, we come to the Janma Bhoomi. One of the problems with large campaigns, including the largest ones we've seen in India, is they become campaigns in English and Hindi. Are we going to see this in Tamil and Malayalam and Bengali?
I'll tell you an interesting story. My mom reads Tamil newspaper, and I try very hard to convince her about the company that I work for. So on a very lighter vein, I always tell, the day my mother acknowledges this, probably the day my job is done. So I do want to go vernacular because that's where our larger community is. I mean, our business community is obviously a very English-speaking community, but we want the brand to reach a lot of people. So you will definitely see some vernacular articulation going forward.
I hope so. I'm going to hold you to this, because
yes, absolutely.
Normally it doesn't happen. Tragedies of
I'll at least do the newspaper that my mom reads, if not anything else.
Okay. So finally, the last kind of leg of this conversation is, tell me how this will help brand Tata, because finally your roots are in Tata, but now it's time for the child to give back almost in many of the Tata companies. So tell me how this connects back with the Tata brand.
Yeah. When we look at our brand, not just in context of this positioning, but overall, right? We are always extremely proud of the heritage and the legacy of the Tata Group backing the TCS brand. And we are always very conscious that we have to, we have to respect that, right? And we have to do justice to that great brand as well. And, in our deeds, in our messaging, in our communication, it should go back and add to the Tata brand, right? So it's a two-way process. We are very conscious about it. We took that into consideration even when we developed this positioning statement. So it's an ongoing process, Anand. That's a very important part of who we are. It's part of our logo. It's part of our identity. So it's very, very important for us. And I'm really hoping that, whatever work we do, whatever messages we communicate, we make the Tata brand even more proud than what we are today.
Okay. So to close, I want to ask you, if you, Rajashree, 1 year from now, how would you know that you've done a good job on this?
Sometimes I have to thank you that you're not my boss, but no, I think as I mentioned, for us, growth is most important. You know, I see marketing as a very strong growth engine for the company. So, you know, when my business comes and tells me that Rajashree Marketing helped me grow, I think that is the greatest testimony that I have. And of course, the overall brand TCS, we want to see the brand grow. We want the brand to be vibrant. We want the brand to be relevant to its community that we operate. So I think those are the dreams, you know, and we definitely hope to build one of the best brands coming out of India. If it is already not that, but I know we can go much higher. And, you know, I think that's really the dream that we have.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Rajashree.
Thanks for your time. Thanks for having me, Anand. Thanks a lot.
And that was Rajashree Yar defining for us TCS's new brand positioning and purpose. Now he is presenting the Melt Cheat Sheet. Millennials today want to be in an organization where their work will be valued. Brands should not want a purpose. They need to find a purpose. Companies need to take steps for the right reasons in order to be trustworthy and value-centric. With that, it's a wrap on this episode of Melt. To follow us on social media, our handle is Ready to Melt, and stay updated with all that's happening in the world of advertising and marketing with our daily Melt updates on our website readytomelt.com. I shall see you next week, same time, same place. Goodbye.